Do you like fishing or eating fish? Do you enjoy recreation on the Lower Chippewa River? Then start thinking about what's in our water. The Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources hands out fish consumption advisories to protect public health and the environment. There are several different anthropogenic or human-caused sources of fish contaminants. These contaminants cause potential health problems for humans who consume fish from affected waters. Chemicals such as dioxins, PCBs, and mercury are among the list of water contaminants that can affect the health of people who eat fish. We will focus on mercury, one of the more publicized fish contaminants. Before our discussion on mercury, let's touch on the concept of biomagnification and bioaccumulation. Biomagnification is the increasing concentration of a chemical, element, or compound such as methylmercury as it moves up the food chain. This can be explained in that the phytoplankton and zooplankton are exposed first, then, as you move up the chain, each corresponding species eats more of what's below of it on the chain. Therefore, the top predators have the highest concentrations of a particular substance. Bioaccumulation simply refers to the concentration of the substance within a species. Older fish have higher concentrations because they have been alive longer and have consumed more prey. Like some household cleaning products, mercury is poisonous. In its simplest form, mercury is a chemical element. Studies show the main source of mercury to lakes is through the combustion of coal. The Midwest's main source of power is through coal power plants. Even UW-Eau Claire uses coal as a source of power. The fish contaminant mercury is actually a different form of the element called methylmercury. It is an organic compound that can accumulate in species. Fish consumption advisories recommend different weekly or monthly consumption guidelines based off fish size. Pregnant women and children are guided to consume less fish than other adults. This is attributed to evidence that methylmercury is a neurotoxin that can cause neurological defects in developing embryos as it accumulates in your brain. The FDA sets a safe threshold at no more than 1 part per million within fish tissue. So what can you do about these issues? Read and understand fish consumption advisories. Become conscious of your personal and family's diet. Become energy aware. Know where your energy comes from. Talk to local representatives and push your city or co-op to switch to clean forms of energy such as wind, nuclear, or hydroelectric. Contact local politicians or organizations about how energy changes can be supported. In conclusion, whether you are an avid angler or just an outdoor enthusiast who enjoys the Lower Chippewa River, these issues involving fish contaminants and their sources affects you. Fish consumption advisories are issued to help guide people about what fish are safe to eat and helps you avoid potential health problems of consuming the fish. Together, we can all contribute in taking small steps to reduce the sources of these contaminants. And maybe one day, fish consumption advisories will not be needed to keep you healthy. Now that's a vision we can all live with.